Hello and welcome to Carwale. Today I'm going to start off with a question. How many types of gearboxes do you know? Yes, there are many, and people who know can let us know in the comment sections below. And people who want to know more can log on to our website. Coming back to the question, you know the basics. There's a manual transmission like this where there's a clutch to engage and change gears with a gear lever. Then there's an automatic gearbox where there's no clutch pedal and you can simply select a drive mode through a gear lever or select a dial. Now, what if I tell you there's a semi-automatic one which doesn't have a clutch pedal, but you can still engage gears through this gear lever. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to this new technology which Hyundai calls the IMT or Intelligent Manual Transmission. Hyundai has introduced this IMT to their successful compact SUV, the Venue. Design or styling-wise, there's no change apart from the fact that this trim is based on the Sport version, which gets a bit of a cosmetic treatment. This Sport package adds a new contrasting look to the SUV thanks to a gloss black grille with a red insert and intake surrounds in the front bumper. Then, there are dark grey roof rails in contrast to the red side decals, brake calipers, and other red accents on the outside. Even inside, there are only a few changes. For example, there is a new flat bottom steering wheel with red stitching, dark grey upholstery with red piping, and loads of red accents in its interior. The standard version just doesn't get this dose of red elements. Now that this version is not very different from the standard Venue, today we will solely focus on telling you about the advantages and disadvantages of having this gearbox. To start off, well, you have the best of both worlds. The control from a manual gearbox and some convenience of an automatic transmission. You are completely relieved of the clutch operation as there's no clutch pedal at all. Your left leg is at ease at all times and this helps quite a lot, especially in bumper-to-bumper traffic in the city. Also, what you still have is a full control of shifting gears manually at your will. As a result, there's all the driving involvement of a manual transmission which an automatic car may lack. Then, fuel efficiency is a big concern for most buyers. Thankfully, there's not much of a big difference between the RI claim figures of this trim and the manual turbo version. Do note, the Hyundai Venue IMT is offered only with the 1-litre turbo petrol engine producing 118 bhp of power and 172 Nm of torque. While its manual version is rated at 18.2 kmpl, this clutchless 6-speed manual IMT delivers 17.8 kmpl. Now, that's not at all a big disparity if you ask. And we would believe in Hyundai's claim that this one doesn't compromise on fuel efficiency and performance. After all, it still uses a conventional manual gearbox underneath. Interestingly, the gearbox is smooth and there's no head nod movement with the shifting of gears. Be it any transmission, you know the process of shifting gears involves a slight delay. Generally, it's observed in AMT and manual transmissions that this shift induces a back and forth movement of the driver. In this version, it is well contained and even matches the revs automatically. It just works beautifully with this 1-litre turbo mill. After all, it's a gem of an engine when it comes to excellent drivability. You can make good progress post the 2000 RPM mark when there's a nice strong push as the turbo spools up. Now, take a look at this. even when you floor the gas pedal, the power delivery is very linear and it never feels abrupt with its throttle response. This engine freely revs up to its red line at 6500 RPM, letting you push it through each gear. However, it's got a good low and mid range, so you'd be ideally doing low speeds in a higher gear easily without the need of constant changing of gears. That said, the intelligent gearbox suggests you to do that whenever there's a need. Now let's tell you about its creep function. I've started the car and I want to move ahead. My right foot is on the brake pedal. I slot the car in first, release the handbrake, and slowly start releasing the brake. You'll notice that the car starts creeping ahead automatically. That too without any throttle input. This is particularly very helpful and adds to the convenience in stop and go traffic. All you have to do is modulate the brake at low speeds and if there's a need, give it a little gas. This creep function along with hill hold works even better on upslopes without letting the car move backwards. We didn't have to use the handbrake, which usually gets imperative with a manual gearbox. Now take a look at this. I'm in second gear and I come to a complete halt. Now without changing the gear, I just start accelerating and the car starts moving ahead without any resistance. This means in bumper-to-bumper traffic, it can cut down your hassle of not just engaging the clutch, but also constant shifting from first to second. And since the power band is quite wide, you can literally speed up and slow down in this gear. That's almost like the convenience of an automatic. People learning to drive a car always have to face the issue of stalling it. You always have to be in the right gear and modulate the clutch and throttle accordingly. This concern is eliminated completely as it's just impossible to stall this vehicle. Even if you're in the wrong gear at wrong speeds, it will try its best to amble along. Worst case, it will beep with a warning sign on the instrument cluster to shift down. We even tried different situations, like stopping in 6th gear without shifting down. But it just didn't stall. Apart from beeping and telling me to shift down, it continued to move ahead. If this would have been a manual version and I wouldn't have engaged the clutch, the car would have given a jerk and stalled. Thankfully, it doesn't happen in this case. It's the same when you move up the gears. For example, now I'm in first gear, I start to accelerate, and as the revs build, I know when to shift a gear. Well, anyone who knows to drive will get to know. Unless you're learning or maybe deaf to not hear the engine whirring sound. Yeah, so whatever may be the case, this instrument cluster shows you the right gear to be in. Now, it's very affordable than the proper automatic DCT version of the Venue. But more interestingly, it's not very expensive than the manual version of this SUV. The Hyundai Venue IMT or DCT is offered only with the 1-liter turbo petrol engine. If you compare it with the prices of the turbo manual, the DCT is easily a lakh rupee more. But the IMT is just about rupees 15 to 25,000 over the manual counterpart, of course, depending on the corresponding variant. I spoke to some car buyers explaining them this new technology. Automatic car buyers like the fact that there are clutchless shifts, but still were not very convinced that they have to shift by themselves. Then, manual car drivers loved the fact that there's no clutch pedal, but they were still worried that they'll have to unlearn the process of not using the left leg and yet shift gears. Well, the good thing is, it's quite easy to get used to. Now, even if things look pretty simple on the go, there's an intelligent little complex system to back it up. The absence of a clutch pedal has brought in a transmission gear shift lever or TGS paired with an intention sensor. When one is about to change gears, this sensor tells an electronic transmission control unit, which is also called the TCU, which in turn signals the hydraulic actuators. These engage and disengage the usual clutch and pressure plates along with the functioning of the concentric slave cylinder and clutch tube. This might sound pretty intense to some buyers, and the complexity might raise questions about its reliability in the long run. However, the good thing is that nothing apart from the actuators or the sensors that has actually changed. Now, such an innovative technology, which adds to the driver's convenience, could have had a far reach. But sadly, it's limited only to this petrol turbo option. It would have been great to have it in its diesel model as well. After all, the oil burner of this Venue SUV is a silent, refined, and a very frugal powertrain. The availability of this IMT would have also helped in Hyundai to bring in more buyers. This is a first and one-of-a-kind technology that people might take time to get used to. Some might get accustomed to it, while some might just avoid it. Well, that only time will tell. For now, this whole package looks like quite an interesting proposition to consider.